Hello, you're welcome to the news in brief on Graphic Online. In the headlines, National Identification Authority says Ghana Card will be ready for all banking transactions by January 2022. BOG issues scam alert on Ghana's World Remit and labels it as a money doubling scheme. Former President Mahama reacts to EC's assertion that the 2020 elections was peaceful. Takrady woman accused of faking pregnancy and kidnap returns to court on November 11th, and former Aviation Minister Kofi Adda dies at age 65. News in Brief is brought to you by Graphic News Plus.
Download your Graphic News Plus now and choose your preferred package daily, weekly, monthly, and annually, and access free news on various interest areas as well. Graphic News Plus, connecting people through news.
And now the news in brief. The National Identification Authority says it has completed building its verification platform to enable all financial institutions to accept the Ghana Card for transactions. Already, Galbank, Stanbic, and UBA have started accepting the Ghana Card as a form of verification for banking transactions.
According to the NIA, the move follows the successful onboarding of the three banks' verification system to the NIA platform. All other banks have been given a grace period up to the end of the year 2021 to build and onboard their systems to the platform and connect all their branches.
The Bank of Ghana has identified a money doubling scheme operating in Ghana under the pseudonym World Remit. According to the BOG, this fraudulent scheme is distinct from the globally renowned fintech World Remit, which is in the business of international fund transfers. The BOG issued a press statement to alert the public today. Former President John Dramani Mahama is in the Central Region as part of the Thank You Tour. Today, he reacted to the assertion by the Electoral Commission that the 2020 elections was cost-efficient and most peaceful.
Yɛde kɔ Supreme Court. Supreme Court ɛkɔbu atɛm etiaɛ. Na me ɛnyɛ hwee sɛ ɔmo bu tiaɛ. But ɔhwɛ ɛkwan a ɔmo faa so ɛde bu tiaɛ a na ɛnyɛ ne kwan so a. Yɛayɛ Supreme Court petition ɛwɔ Ghana hada. Adeɛ a yɛfrɛ no interrogatories sɛ wɔbɛbusa Electoral Commission questions. Wɔ lawyerfoɔ bɛtwerɛ questions ne yɛde ama Electoral Commission sɛ yɛpɛ sɛ Muma yemuyaye sa ansesi. Abra nana akufu adode 2012 election call Supreme Court. Omu jitum, ema faijan, ema emuyaye questions omu enyi na omu emuyaye. Enso edru ya so die. Ya se 7-0, ya mpene ema mumbusa Electoral Commission question. Nana, Electoral Commission, wona oshe ijuma no so, ema abatu ono ekoso. Wo ena ewo se ojitum se bibi ebesi bia eye me ena mehwe so 2012 ye frere general mosquito e mane begina adakam 2020 so ye san frere no mane begina adakam 2012 ye frere afarijan no na ye electoral commissioner e mane begina adakam e mi ebusa no questions e fa abato no hu nyina 2020 de Edru ye so Mami Jim Mensa Bejina adakam ni mbusao Abatu ono hon questions sir.
The Ghana Police Service has introduced a shuttle service for its personnel. This is to help facilitate movement of personnel to and from their places of residence to their various duty points. According to the police, the program has been implemented in 15 out of the 18 police operational regions and it is intended to ease the burden of commute on officers as well as to ensure that personnel who carry weapons for duty do so under safe conditions.
The police administration in a social media post said it had deployed buses on designated routes with pick-up and drop-off points to ensure the safe and easy transportation of personnel, especially during the rush hour when movement along the roads is especially a struggle. The police say some members of the public had expressed concern about the practice of police personnel boarding commercial vehicles with weapons and the possible danger posed to occupants of these vehicles. The shuttle service is therefore to boost morale in service and to ensure that the police officers and commuting public go about their duties in safety and dignity.
The Takoradi Harbour Circuit Court has adjourned to November 11th the case involving Josephine Pinyin Mensah, the woman who allegedly faked her pregnancy and kidnapping in Takoradi.
According to the defense counsel for Josephine, the prosecuting team is here to furnish them with all intended documents they will be relying on for the case. The lead counsel for the defense, Philip Fifi Backman, said that planned case management process could not take place because the prosecutor failed to furnish the court and defense team with the evidence.
The law is that we have to disclose everything they intend to rely on. Their witnesses, their witness statements, the evidences they intend to rely on. So today, they were to furnish that so that you will see that we have been furnished with these documents. Then we take a date to do our case management conference, or we do the case management conference today. Unfortunately, there are some documents which prosecution need to add, and the substantive prosecutor couldn't attend court, so we have to send all the documents back to him to look through, because he's doing the prosecution, so that he comes. So we have taken a date, the documents have been given back to them, they go and look through the documents, and the next time we come, on the next agenda date, we come and do the CMC, if they serve us before we come to court. If they do not serve us before we come to court, then they come and serve us on that day, you will have to take another day to go and do the CMC, because we need to go through the document.
And in our final story, on a rather sad note, former aviation minister Joseph Kofi Adah has died. He died in Accra on Thursday morning at the age of 65 after a short illness. He previously served as a member of parliament for Navrongo Central on the ticket of the New Patriotic Party. Thank you for watching. We'll see you again with another edition. Stay safe and protect yourself from COVID-19. For more news, visit graphic.com.gh or log on to Facebook at Daily Graphic and on YouTube at GraphicGH. I am Enoch Dafafrimpong.
Subscribe now.